So Victor Prost made a video back in January. It was 7.5 months now, talking about why the whole thing about Stefan Molyneux and being a bit terrible person is all wrong. We only made one video, and that was about defooing, which is probably the most undefendable fucking thing you can possibly try and do. But he tries, and to his credit, he doesn't understand the problem is. So what I agree with Victor Prost on is that you really just can't just call anyone who is a fan of Stefan Molyneux a cult, because there's. Oh, I'll get into that in just a second. And the other part is that if someone actually is abusive in your life, you should by all means disconnect from them and don't associate with them, especially if they're not interested in changing. And I'm talking about real abuse here. Physical violence, emotional violence, people who are insulting you and bringing you down all the time, people who are hitting you, abusing you physically. Those are the type of people that you want to outcast from your life. But the problem is that's not what Stefan Molyneux and defooing is about. First of all, there's three different types of Stefan Molyneux fans, and this is why you can't categorize all of Stefan Molyneux's fandom as being a cult, because there's three different levels. You have the outermost group who probably just listen to the podcast or watch the YouTube channel. They really agree with the libertarian stuff. That's what brought them on board, and that's what's keeping them around. They're probably not too interested in the UPB stuff. They're probably not interested in the misogynist MRA shit. They're really not interested, or maybe topically interested, in the whole child spanking issue. This is where I was about a couple years ago, and then I found out this guy was terrible, and I unsubscribed from him and tried to not use his stuff too much, except here and there. Because some of the stuff he does do is fairly decent. A lot of the stuff he does do is just really bad, or just, what the fuck am I watching? And then you have the more inner core members, people who are a part of the forum, people a part of the chat rooms. They're probably a little bit more on his side on UPB, more on his side on, child rearing and spanking, MRAs, and that sort of thing, whatever. And then you have the really inner core members, the people who are philosopher kings, people who are gold, silver, platinum, whatever the hell he's got going on. Those are the people who donate lots of time, lots of money, and who essentially shut themselves off from all of society except for FDR members. And this is not really known outside of the clique too much. It's not really outside of the layers of the onions, so to speak, is because the higher up you are in the FDR group, inner core, the more privy to information that you are, right? You don't get access to the details of defooing and stuff like that outside of the group. You're sometimes you can be clued in if you watch a Sunday show, and you can actually see what he's doing, and it's really kind of like bad. But for the most part, not everyone is really kind of privy to this information. And a lot of this information is out. There's a couple websites you can go to. First of all, there's a YouTube channel called True Shibs. I'll link that below. And FDR Liberated. Now, there's another anti-Stefan Molyneux website, which I don't recommend. Their whole thing is, like I was talking to Eagle Eye a while back, that they're basically coming to the right conclusion through the wrong means. They're more objecting to them losing their family members because they're ultra-Christian right-wing conservatives, and their kid went became an atheist, and that caused a bunch of conflict. So I wouldn't recommend that one, but FDR Liberated is great. True Shib's channel is really great. So what really is defooing? Well, defooing, if you listen to the defenders of Stefan Molyneux, or when Stefan Molyneux defends themselves from these accusations, is that, oh no, we're just telling people who have abusive people in their lives who are not willing to fucking change to just disconnect from them and live more happy and useful lives. But the problem is, that's not exactly what's going on. I'm going to give you a couple of examples. This is from FDRLiberated.com. There's a multi-part podcast entitled "But My Parents Were Nice," which he describes how even though if your parents were nice, if you remember your parents being nice, that they were really abusive and they were really bad, and you just need to disconnect and defoo from them. And this is very typical of what cults do. They try to convince you that your happy childhood was not happy at all, and that your life is so much better now that you're in the cult. There's also a podcast that proves why you don't love your parents. Again, this is just more just bullshit and convincing you that your childhood was a whole lot worse than what it was. There's an 80-page book that explains your child why your childhood was a prison. It's called On Truth, The Tyranny of Illusion. And that any new members urge to read. In fact, he urges everyone to read all of his books. And that's one of them. And he does really describe how your wonderful, happy childhood is really an evil prison. And then, of course, you got the conversations in the Saturday pod or the Sunday podcast, which he there's another one where he does now on top of that one. So I think it's on Wednesday or something, where he gets you to call in, and he just, you know, if you try to talk about libertarianism stuff or whatever, he's going to be like, well, you know, tell me about your parents' childhood. Tell me about your childhood and get them in. And because FDR is a bait and switch program. They bring you in by talking about libertarianism stuff, and then it's all about, well, tell me about your parents. Why don't you read this book? Join our forum. Donate. Become a philosopher king. Disconnect from your family. And that's what FDR is about. Purely, that's what FDR is about. It's a bait and switch program. And if you don't believe that I'm mischaracterizing Stefan Molyneux, or I'm putting words in his mouth or whatever, I'm gonna link below this video where he talks about how explicitly says that it's a bait and switch program, that it's bringing in libertarians, and their whole point is to talk about their family. And of course, from then on, he'll convince you that your parents are bad. But anyways, in these Saturday things, he just dresses you down. Like any time your parent is, you have like one bad parent who spanked you, and the other one was good. He'll convince you that the other one that was so-called good is even worse than the one that was spanking you, and then try to convince you to disconnect from them. There's a video that he'd taken down, and that talked about how if you didn't vote for Ron Paul, they were inflicting force upon you by proxy, and therefore you need to disconnect from them. He got a lot of shit for that one, even within his own group, and so he had to take that one down. But that's kind of the part of the course. It's anyone who disagrees with FDR or the NAP or UPP or whatever is just violent fucking thugs, and you need to get rid of them. And there's just no defending this shit. And what's really great, well, it's not really great, it's really bad, but Stefan Molyneux's wife used to have a show on there called Ask a Therapist, where this is the huge red flag that no one fucking picked up on, except for people outside of the group, that Stefan Molyneux's wife had a show called Ask a Therapist, and there was an episode, a couple episodes before, where he was just having conversations with her, convincing her to do this show, and dressing her down and getting her, you know, her problems with having ethical violations attached to her credentials, and maybe losing her license over it, where he was convincing her that's not a problem because, you know, it's great or whatever. And he convinces her to make the show where he's telling her to defoo for all these reasons. And they're all taken down now, and the reason why they're all taken down now, every episode that features his wife is off the thing. And you'll notice there's a reason why there's a lot of missing episodes from FDR, because he had to take them down. Because his wife was suspended for advocating this defooing process. And what's interesting is that she was only suspended and not terminated. Her license was not terminated. If she was doing this in her public office by herself, she would have had her license terminated, no questions asked. I mean, it would have been a huge, huge ethical violation. But it wasn't. The reason why is because she never actually advocated these situations at all in her public life. Never did. And they went through all of her files and they couldn't find any examples of it. So if she really did agree with Stefan Molyneux that this was a good idea to do, she definitely didn't do it in practice. You know, it's like I say, you know, maybe, you know, it's a good idea to rob, you know, liquor stores, but I'm not going to do it. But yeah, this is all just tribalist nonsense. Victor Prost unfriended me from Facebook because I dared fucking question the great Stefan Molyneux. And this was about a few months after him and I were talking about how tribalism was bullshit, that, you know, that my guy needs to be defended no matter what, even if he's wrong because he's, you know, on my team. Sorry, I don't buy into that shit at all. The biggest targets for me are people who agree with me. If you fucking do stupid things, if you say dangerous shit, if you say really just bad things, I'm gonna call you out on it. I don't care if you're a libertarian, I don't care if you're a zeitgeist, or I don't care if you're socialist, communist, minarchist, whatever. I'm gonna call you out on it. And it's something that everyone should do. Tribalism should only ever be in, like, sports, right? It's the only thing you should ever be tribalist about. Like, go your sports team, all the other sports teams are wrong. But when you start doing it with ideologies, that's when things get dangerous, that's when things get ugly, and that's when you end up with assholes like fucking Maoist Rebel News, who goes around telling people that fucking the DPRK ain't so fucking bad. This is the same thing to me. I don't see any difference between people defending the DPRK and fucking people defending FDR over the defuing thing. I don't. And mostly it has to do with people just not understanding or disregarding information that is critical to their ideology, or at least figures of their ideology. And I encourage everyone to do the same. Infighting is a good thing. It keeps all the assholes out, keeps you looking nice, you know, brushing all the shit off your shirt. Till next time, peace.